So as most of you guys know, the only real cool thing that happened at the Oscars was Will Smith smacked Chris Rock. I'm not saying it's cool as in like, hey, I agree with this illegal activity and violence done on a comedian who is kind of just doing his job. That's what comedians do. They just make fun of everybody. So I'm not condoning that. When I say cool thing, it means it's like, hey, that's interesting. And all the rest of this stuff, it's just rot. Nobody gives a rip about the beautiful blue checks anymore, specifically their opinions or their moral grandstanding. And after this slap happened, people were up in arms of like, oh, he should sue him over this. You know, like just take him to the cleaners. And it just grated on me because I was thinking about how, what would you rather have someone do to you? Slap you in the face, because presumably, let's say you crossed the line and you did something jacked up. Now, comedian against a public figure, I don't think that was necessarily against the line. If you really want to punish a comedian, don't laugh. And that's how you really punish a comedian. I believe a good comedian would far rather get backhanded than have an audience just do crickets after a joke at a really big event. That's how you punish a comedian, so you don't do illegal activities. And by the way, Will Smith should have been arrested. If he hadn't have been a minority celebrity, he would absolutely have been arrested for battery. Anyway, that didn't happen because our beautiful elites have special treatment over folks like you and I. But it got me thinking about the Old West because my wife and I are watching cowboy movies right now. I'm out on a farm. I got horses and stuff. So we're watching cowboy movies. I'm trying to embrace the new changes that are coming in my life and the different seasons. But back then, if you said something jacked up and you attacked somebody's honor, you could just do a good old-fashioned beatdown. Now, it wasn't a bullying thing. It was just that's what you do, and you kind of settle it like that. The only place where that exists now, outside of like the UFC or actual sanctioned events, is hockey. I'm not a hockey player and grow up with hockey. I don't generally watch sports, but I like watching hockey. And I remember one of my very first games I was watching, they were playing hockey, and all of a sudden two dudes get ticked at each other from opposing teams. They come together, throw off gloves, and the ref gets right in the middle of it. I'm like, oh, this is getting broken up. But the craziest thing in the world happened. The ref didn't break it up. He like stopped reffing hockey to start refereeing a fist fight, you know? And so they're just battling out. I'm like, how is this happening in the 21st century? What is going on? And somebody who was with me leaned in and explained, listen, these guys are wearing knives on their feet and they're, you know, have basic clubs in their hands. And if they don't stop right now and fist fight it out, worse things will happen out on the ice, you know, more lethal, terrible things can happen. And I'm like, hey, that's so fiercely practical. That's so fiercely true. Of course it's far from ideal of let's turn the other cheek and everyone get along and no violence, period. But I'm just saying in a world of violence, this is a really practical approach. And it got me thinking today, there's far worse things you can do to somebody that's perfectly legal and morally okay with everybody than slapping somebody or punching somebody who is offending honor. Now we don't really have such a thing as honor. People just don't really seem to care about it. We lost our honor a long time ago, and therefore we don't feel the compulsion to defend our honor. It is also a little weird that Will Smith is defending his wife's honor when he lets her sleep with other men in an open marriage concept of like, no, defend your wife's honor in the bedroom through monogamy and exclusivity of romance and covenant before you get mad at a comedian for doing what comedians do, of like that just passive aggressive cuckold frustration brought out publicly on a comedian was really, really ill advised. But I'm using it as a stepping off point to make a greater point of today, where you're not allowed to punch someone or take someone to task who really just kind of deserves it. Everyone knows they deserve it, of like, hey, that guy was being a prick and deserves to get busted up, and everyone would agree with it. You're not allowed to do that. And maybe that's for the best, but I will say that this is for the worst. You can sue somebody into oblivion. You can take somebody that's innocent, that hasn't done anything, and you just want to harass them and bankrupt them. You could overwhelm them with enough money, with legal fees and bullying, take away their livelihood, take away their house, wreck their relationship. You could do all that in a very legal and moral upstanding thing. The blue checks and the Hollywood elites weren't calling for forgiveness and turn the other cheek of Chris Rock. They weren't, doing anything of such a like, sue him, take him to the cleaners. You know, and that's what they want, is immediately any semblance of violence can be met with unlimited repercussions that are far, far, far worse, in my opinion, than the act of violence itself. Would you rather get slapped or taken to court for all your worth in a legal battle that may drag on for a year or two or three and cost you hundreds of thousands of dollars in legal bills and damages? Now, that is far worse. Or would you rather be slapped, or would you rather be publicly defamed, canceled, fired from your employment, and denied jobs elsewhere? What would you rather have for you personally? And I also see just the moral inconsistency of our Hollywood beautiful people elites in calling and condemning any act of violence as absolutely wrong, while at the same time maintaining that doing the worst conceivable acts of violence against babies, pre-born babies in the womb, is okay. You can literally shred them, dismember them while they're still alive in a womb, murdering them. Now we're murdering well over a million babies a year in the United States, and that's okay because my body, my choice. Hashtag, hey, guess what? A baby's body isn't the mom's body. The mom's body is her body. The baby's body is not. This is just the weakest, weakest of the weakest. Really stupid, incongruent, inconsistent thought. And so anyway, it's a genocide against the unborn. One day we'll morally sort it all out and be like, hey, we're just killing babies all along. I'm like, yeah, in the name of convenience. And then some hero will be like, no, it's a rape thing. Of like, in the far, far, now I'm getting into it because I'm just ticked about this, because it is morally reprehensible that we murder folks. Even if a rapist commits a horrible wrong against an innocent woman, it will not bring that innocent woman peace to now murder an innocent offspring. That's not going to bring peace. You're actually going to compound your trauma in that case. It sucks. It's terrible. It's horrible. I think the rapist should be castrated and thrown away into jail with the key thrown away as well. So anyway, we have a difference of morality and values that split the country in two. To me, the left, it's evil. Abortion, it's evil. It's super twisted, demonic evil. And to the left, I'm really evil too, and I get it. We just have a difference. It's what happens when we remove our theological moral base. All hell breaks loose in society, and that's what's happening now. Just food for thought as we're trying to be better warrior poets, moral, loving, sacrificial defenders of other folks. And man, train hard, train smart. Love you guys. See you next time.